Hello my dear children, I hope all of you are doing absolutely great by staying safe indoors and following the lockdown very strictly. This is Sarshna ma'am, your science teacher. My family and I have been strictly following lockdown beyond doubt. And I hope all of you have also been following this because of it's your own safety, it's for your country's safety and also for the safety of entire world. Let's fight this pandemic together. During this lockdown period, there are lots of things to pick up to do. Of course, as students, you have subject to learn. On top of that, our school also providing classes and make use of it because we know that learning should never stop. Before starting the class, everyone should be ready with their copy and pen and make notes of whatever topic is there and learn it yourself. Write down the answers of the questionnaire given at the last of the PPT to your science homework copy. And whatever topic is covered will be tested at the beginning of the school days. After lockdown, take this phase positively and work hard for the better result. I am with you as usual with all the possible supports. Let's start with the chapter first, chemical reaction and equation, which is the first chapter of chemistry. What is changes? Changes is the law of nature. We observe various types of changes around us. Plants grow into trees, a child grows into an adult, water evaporates, milk changes into curd, etc. are the changes around us. Which among these are physical changes and which one are chemical changes? To differentiate, we first need to know what physical or chemical changes mean. Physical change is a process in which the substance experiences a change in its physical properties like shape, size, appearance or state. Thus, no change in the internal structure or molecular composition. A chemical change, on the other hand, results in the formation of new substances. Entirely, the atoms of one or more substance are combined or rearranged to form new substances. Chemical reaction. Chemical reactions are everywhere. Cooking, respiration, rusting, combustion, formation of curd, etc. A chemical reaction is a process where the reactant gets converted into a product which may be under an influence of catalyst. Catalyst which speed up the rate of reaction. Now the question arises, how do we identify a chemical reaction? A chemical reaction is identified by any of these characteristics: changes in state, change in color, evolution of gas, change in temperature, formation of precipitation. First one, change in state. For example, when a mixture of hydrogen and oxygen is ignited with electric spark at room temperature, liquid water is formed. Second, change in color. When red lead oxide is heated, yellow lead monoxide is formed. Third, evolution of a gas. When heating a mixture of potassium chloride and magnesium dioxide gives oxygen gas. Changes in temperature. During a chemical reaction, energy is either evolved or absorbed. The energy evolved that we call as an exothermic reaction, or energy absorbed may be in the form of heat or light, which is called endothermic reaction. For example, when a small quantity of water is added to quicklime, calcium oxide, a large amount of heat is evolved, which is called exothermic reaction. Another one, when limestone, calcium carbonate is burned to obtain quicklime, in this reaction heat is absorbed, which is called endothermic reaction, which is already studied in 8th class also. And the last characteristic is the formation of precipitate. In certain reaction, when solution of two reagents are mixed, one of the products formed gets precipitate immediately. Color of the precipitates depends upon the reaction used in this reaction. For example, when silver nitrate solution is mixed with a solution of sodium chloride, white precipitate of silver chloride is formed. Chemical equation. A chemical equation is the symbolic representation of a chemical reaction in the form of symbols and formula. A chemical equation must follow the law of conservation of mass, according to which the mass of the reactant must be equal to the mass of the product. Here the an example, the chemical equation represents a chemical reaction. For example, when magnesium react with oxygen, it will form magnesium oxide. Here the reactants are written on the left side and the product is written on the right side. An arrow is placed between them to show the direction of reaction. Before moving the next topic, it's important to know what is chemical formula. Here chemical formula of a substance is the symbolic representation of the actual number of atoms present in one molecule of that substance. For example, the formula of one molecule of water is H2O. It shows that one molecule of water is made up of two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. In the same case, we take one more example, that is one molecule of sulfuric acid, that is H2SO4. It shows that one molecule of sulfuric acid is made up of two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of sulfur and four atoms of oxygen. That is the main difference between chemical equation and chemical formula. Okay, then what is the importance of chemical equation? What is the advantage of uses of this chemical equation? First we say that the representation of actual chemical reaction becomes easy by using equation. That means it saves time and space in writing. Second one, to prepare a known amount of product, we can calculate the amount of reactants to be taken. And the third, we say that the effect of temperature, pressure and concentration of the rate of reaction can be investigated with the help of perfectly balanced chemical equation. That means what is the importance of chemical equation? That means balance equation, that every chemical compound has a molecular formula which cannot be changed. For example, H2 plus O2 gives H2O. In the same way, H2 plus O2 also gives H2O2, that is hydrogen peroxide. So in this case we need balance equation. If there is an advantage of chemical equation, there will be chances of limitation of chemical equation. Some limitations of chemical equations will also be there. For example, it does not mention the state of the matter. That means it does not mention that it is solid, liquid or gas. Second one, it does not give any information regarding the speed of the reaction. That means how much time it takes to complete this reaction. That will not be explained by this chemical equation. Next, it does not give any information regarding the concentration of substance, color change, production and absorption of heat. Okay. Characteristics of chemical equation. The equation must represent known fact. The equation must contain the correct formula for the reactants and product. And the law of conservation of must be satisfied. Law of conservation we already studied. Now next, types of chemical equation. Chemical equation can be classified into two types, balanced chemical equation and unbalanced chemical equations. The name indicates what is the difference between balance and unbalanced. First, here that according to the law of conservation of mass, total mass must be equal on the both side of the equation. That means the reactant and the product will be equal. This type of equation is known as balanced chemical reaction. For example, 2 magnesium plus oxygen gives 2 magnesium oxide. Here both sides have 2 atoms of magnesium and 2 atoms of oxygen. Another type of chemical equation is skeletal or unbalanced equation. Skeletal equation are those equations which shows that the reactant and the product so form without balancing them. Here an example, magnesium plus oxygen gives magnesium oxide. hydrogen plus oxygen, which gives H2O. It is also known as unbalanced. That means the reactant and the product mass will be different. Here we easily understood what is the difference between unbalanced and balanced equation. In unbalanced equation, you just check that in right hand side and the left hand side. In left hand side, the number of hydrogen atom is 2, but in left hand side, that means in product side, it will be 1, and chlorine will be 2 in reactant and product will be 1. That means it is unbalanced. Second, that example, that in reactant the hydrogen atom is 2, the product will be 2, chlorine the reactant will be 2, and in product it will be 2. That means this reaction will be balanced. How to balance a equation? Here the reaction involving the combustion of methane in oxygen to form carbon dioxide and water. Here that reaction is given, that CH4 plus oxygen gives CO2 plus H2O. This reaction is shown in combustion reaction, that is a compound react with oxygen and produce carbon dioxide and water. The technique is to balance the carbon atom first, and then the hydrogen atom, and then the oxygen atom. If the reaction is given, first you select that. If there is any metal, first you balance that metal. Okay. Then after that, hydrogen, and the last one is that oxygen. In this case, the carbon atoms are already balanced. So now we look at the hydrogen atom. There are 4 hydrogen atom on the reactant side and 2 hydrogen atom on the product side. To balance them, we put a coefficient of 2 in front of H2O. You always remember that whatever the values you are going to write, it will be in front of that element or molecules. The hydrogen atoms are now balanced. Due to the coefficient 2 in front of H2O, there are a total of 4 oxygen atoms on the product side. To balance the oxygen atom on both sides, we put a coefficient of 2 in front of oxygen. The chemical equation is now balanced. This is the way how to balance the equation. You just try some more example, okay, which I already given in the last slide. So you practice this and do it in your homework copy. Here are some questions. First question, define a chemical reaction. You define what is chemical reaction. Which observation help you to determine whether a chemical reaction has taken place? Explain the factors with an example. That means what are the factors or how can you identify that chemical reaction will be takes place? You can be explained with an example. Okay, then the second question, why do we need to balance a chemical equation? Okay, what is the importance of that balancing this chemical equation? Second one, using the chemical formula, write balanced chemical equation for the following reactions. First one, carbon disulfide burns in air to give carbon dioxide and sulfur dioxide. So you first write what is the chemical formula for that carbon disulfide, carbon dioxide and sulfur dioxide. Okay, in the same way, potassium metals react with water to give potassium hydrogen hydroxide and hydrogen gas. The third question, balance the following skeleton equation. That means say here some unbalanced equation will be given, you make them to balance. And okay, all the best. We will discuss the remaining topic later. And study well. All the best.